rest upon our hearts. Come on, anybody need the dew in the morning? The dew of Jesus, the dew of the presence of the Holy Spirit, just to rest on your heart. A lot of things been trying to get into our hearts, but our hearts are guarded by the word of the Lord. Our hearts are guarded by the dew of the Holy Spirit, which rests on our heart. Let him saturate you with his glory. Come on, that's what the song says. Is there anybody in the house who wants to be saturated in his glory on today? Come on, ladies. Now, we've been having a good time. Don't act like that. Don't get quiet now. We came in the house to worship. We came in the house to give God the glory. We came in the house to honor him. We came in the house to receive from him. We came in the house as women walking in the word. Do I have any women walking in the word? Where y'all at? Where y'all at? Women walking in the word. Women touched by the word. Women healed by the word. Women whose steps are ordered by the Lord. We bless the name of Jesus. We bless the name of Jesus. We bless the name of Jesus. Come on, invite him to rest. Rest, Jesus. Rest, Jesus. Come on, invite him to rest in your heart today. Invite him to rest in your mind today. Invite him to rise up on the inside of you and take you over. We are yielded to the presence of God today. We are yielded to the power of God today. We are yielded to what it is that God wants to do. For those of you who are watching online, we want to invite you and encourage you to rest in Jesus, to let the dew of the morning rest on your heart, and let the Lord have his way. Hallelujah. Yes, come on, praise him. Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask Elder Teresa to come. We're going to open up in prayer and scripture. And we are going to allow the word of God to rest on our hearts this morning. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, Siloam. Women of God. Oh, this is a celebration for us, ladies. And God gave us a word. I was praying about what to say, what verse he would want to just infuse in your spirit. And he gave me Isaiah 30, verse 21. Rather you turn to the right or to the left, your ears will hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it. So let's look to the Lord. Almighty Father, we lift our hands up high in praise and worship. We give you thanks for the women in our lives and community. We lift our hands up high to show that we are committed to seeing a gender equal world. We thank you, Father, for women who have led the way when the path was uncertain. Father, we ask you to bless all women, single, married, mothers, separated, divorced, or widowed. We ask you to supply all our needs according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Holy Father, we ask that the Spirit of God instruct us in our relationships, ministries, careers, and finances. Heavenly Father, I pray for courage and boldness to face the challenges and embrace the opportunities that come our way. Grant us a Deborah anointing so that we may walk with bravery and confidence, trusting in your guidance and provision. I lift up the cause of women empowerment to you. Break the chains of oppression and discrimination and injustice that have held women back for far too long. Raise up advocates and allies who will tirelessly work to ensure that women have equal opportunity in all spheres of life. Fill the hearts of these women with confidence and self-worth, empowering them to pursue their dreams and aspirations without fear or limitation. May your love and grace be the foundation upon which true equality and empowerment are built. Help us to overcome fear and doubt, stepping out in faith, even when the path is unclear. Give us the boldness to speak truth, stand up for what is right, and pursue our dreams with determination. Let your presence be a source of courage, reminding us that with you, all things are possible. Empower us to live boldly for your glory. Help us to celebrate the women in our lives and value our sisterhood. Give us wisdom to see bias and the voice to speak out against it. Equip us to take action, to seek equality and boldness, to challenge where needed. We are all one in Christ Jesus, for it is in his name that we pray. Amen and amen.
We'll now have our announcements by Sister Kathleen.
Good morning, church. How are you? Good morning, pastors. And our ministers and elders, reverends. We have announcements today for September 8th. With great sorrow, we inform you that the funeral services for Brother William L. Carter are to be held on Thursday, September 12th at 10 a.m. is the viewing. And 11 a.m. services. Please pray for comfort and strength for his family during this sorrowful time. Evangelism 101, Soul Winning Conference on Saturday, September 14th, 11:30 to 4 p.m. Special presenters, Minister Randy and Jans Logan. This is a church-wide event, and we encourage all to attend. Let's learn how to strengthen our witness to the Lord. Liturgical Dance Workshop, Saturday, September 21st, from 2 to 4 p.m. in the sanctuary at Siloam Baptist Church. Come out to learn what liturgical dance is and common movements of dance. This does not require you to commit to the praise dance ministry, but it is an opportunity to learn and try it out. Please see Elder Nicole if you are interested in attending. Siloam family and friends, it's that time. You can help us with the annual Operation Christmas Child Global Outreach. You can start packing your shoe boxes, pick up boxes from the church, or use your own. The deadline is November 10th. Thanks in advance. Contact Sister Rachel Wilford if you need help or you want to help packing. The mid-year ministry reports are due immediately. Please turn them into the secretary's office or send via email to info@siloambc.org. September men's breakfast. Woo! Men, please sign up in the back of the church for the September 21st men breakfast. This great gathering of men will start at 9 a.m. Come out to fellowship, praise God, and eat some really good food. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Just one other friendly announcement for all my young people. Next Sunday is Youth Sunday. I just wanted to remind you about the invitation that I gave for y'all to join me just a little bit closer. just a little bit closer to the front to put down your phones, that you might be able to engage a little bit more with the word. I'm just giving y'all a friendly reminder. Remember, it's an invitation, not a requirement, but an invitation for you to just come up a little bit closer. Parents, you are welcome to sit with them if you would like, but we want to just remind you of that. All right, well, we're going to go ahead and praise the Lord. Is that all right? Yes. Praise team. All right, so can we just take a moment and pray, y'all? Because this morning has been a morning. I don't know, is anybody else experiencing a morning where it feels a little bit like the enemy's trying to disrupt some stuff? But we bind and rebuke the hand of the enemy in the name of Jesus. He gets no glory. Come on, can we lift up the name of Jesus? The one who sustains us, the one who wraps us in his love, the one who gives us grace, the one who moves us, the one who shapes us, the one who makes every crooked path straight.
Yes.
Can we lift up Jesus? Can we lift, come on, I can't hear y'all. Yes. Can we lift up Jesus? Can we act like we came in here to praise his name?
Yes.
Can we act like we came in here to glorify him?
Yes.
Can we act like we know that 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 Jesus is our risen King, that he is our Savior, that he is our Redeemer, that he is our Healer, that he is our way maker.
Yes.
He is our all in all.
Yes.
He is our all in all.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus. Come on, that name is a great name. Jesus.
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 That name breaks every chain. Everything that the enemy thinks he can do, when we say the name of Jesus, it stops him in his tracks. So we came this morning to worship Jesus and to praise his name. And it is to our God that we give all glory, that we give all honor, that we designate all wisdom and strength. It's to our God. It's to our God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh. Come on, can y'all clap your hands like this for me? I will sing praises unto our King, yeah.
I will sing praises unto our King, yeah.
He is creator of everything.
He is creator of everything.
I will exalt him, his name adore, yeah.
I will exalt him, his name adore, yeah.
Honor and reverence forevermore.
Honor and reverence forevermore.
Sing, we lift up our hands to our God, to our God. To thee we ascribe, glory and honor and wisdom and strength. To our God. Praise I will give up to glorify thee.
I will give up to glorify thee.
And I declare that thy name is holy.
And I declare that our name is holy.
You will be exalted above all the heavens.
We will be exalted above all the heavens.
And all thy glory above all the earth.
And all the glory in all the earth.
We lift up our heads to our God, to our God. To thee we ascribe glory and and strength to our God. Oh, oh, we worship you, Jesus. Yeah. We worship.
We worship.
Adore you.
Adore you.
We declare.
We declare.
No one like you.
No one like you.
We worship.
We worship.
Adore you.
Adore you.
We declare.
We declare.
No one like you.
Nobody like you.
We worship.
We worship.
Adore you.
Adore you.
We declare.
We declare.
Nobody like you.
Nobody like you.
We worship.
We worship.
Adore you.
Adore you.
We declare.
We declare.
Nobody like you.
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 The King of Kings.
Nobody like you.
The Lord of Lords.
Nobody like you.
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 We worship,
we worship,
adore you,
adore you.
We declare,
we declare,
nobody like you,
nobody like you.
We worship,
we worship,
adore you,
adore you.
We declare,
we declare,
nobody like you,
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 nobody, 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 nobody,
nobody like you,
nobody. Jesus.
Nobody like you.
Nobody like you, Jesus.
Nobody like you.
You are power.
Nobody like you.
You are strength.
Nobody like
there's
you.
There's nobody like you,
Lord. Nobody like you.
Nobody like you,
Lord. Nobody like you.
Nobody like you,
Lord. Nobody like you.
Oh,
nobody like you.
We worship.
We worship.
Oh, say we worship.
We worship.
Oh, we lift your name, Jesus. Yeah. We worship,
we worship.
Oh, sing, we worship,
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 we worship.
In spirit,
we worship,
and in truth,
we worship.
God, we worship you,
we worship,
we worship you,
we worship,
we worship you,
we worship,
we worship you,
we worship.
Adore you.
Adore you,
adore you,
adore you.
We love you, Jesus.
Adore you.
We love you, Jesus.
Adore you.
Oh, oh.
Adore you.
Oh, oh.
Adore you.
We love you.
Adore you.
Oh, sing, nobody like you.
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 Nobody like you. Couldn't find nobody.
Nobody like you.
Searched all over.
Nobody like you.
Couldn't find nobody.
Nobody like you.
I look high.
Nobody like you.
I look low.
Nobody like you.
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 Nobody, nobody,
nobody, nobody,
nobody like you.
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 Nobody, nobody,
nobody like you.
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 Oh, we worship.
We worship.
Come on, can we lift up our voices in this house? We worship you.
We worship.
Oh, we worship you.
We worship.
Ooh, hey, we worship you.
We worship.
Hey, Jesus, we bow down before your throne. We worship.
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 We bow our knees.
We worship.
We lift our hands.
We worship.
We worship.
We worship.
We worship.
Lift your hands.
We worship.
Oh, ye gates.
We worship.
And be it the love.
We worship.
The everlasting God.
We worship.
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 You worthy God.
We worship.
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 We worship. Nobody like you. Oh, nobody like you. Nobody like you, Jesus. Nobody like you, Lord. nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord. No. Oh. Oh. Jesus, when you accepted Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, washed over you. And it says, the scripture says, behold, all things are passed away. And see, you are a new creature in Christ. Can we give God the glory for being a new creature? Come on, where are my women walking in the word? Where are my new creature women? Do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? Our identity is found in him. The one who washes us and cleanses us and mortifies us in his word. I said he washes us, he cleanses us, and he orders our steps in his word.
You got that?
He washes us, he cleanses us, and he orders my steps in his word. He washes us, he cleanses us, and he orders my steps in his word.
Well, y'all, it's time for me to welcome you. But if you don't feel welcome by now, I don't know what to tell you. But for those of you who are new to the house, welcome to Siloam Baptist Church. This is God's house of hope, healing, and wholeness, where we believe in teaching God's word, praying God's word, and living God's word. If you're watching online, welcome. We want to invite you to come on in the house. We're located at 1329 Willow Street in Norristown, Pennsylvania. I promise you, service is not as good online as it is on in here. Can you feel the Spirit moving? Can you feel the Spirit moving?
The one that washes us and cleanses us and orders our steps in his word. It said he washes us, he cleanses us, and he orders our steps in his word.
We're going to continue in the flow of worship. Y'all vibe into this right here. The Spirit of God is definitely, some of y'all are getting washed over right now. You're being cleansed right now. Right now, he is ordering your steps. When you leave this place, you won't leave this place the same. But you're going to be different. You're going to feel different. You're going to think different. Thinking not strange. When stuff starts happening out of nowhere, I decree and declare blessings upon blessings. Breakthrough upon breakthrough. Healing upon healing. Provision. Whatever you need. Whatever you need. By his word you shall receive. He says, anything that you ask in my name, it shall be given unto thee.
Let him wash you,
but she's coming.
I'm trying.
let us sing. Amen. Melodies from heaven rain down on me. Our theme, women walking in the word. We decided to sing songs about being in the presence of God. So the next song we're getting ready to do is an original. Okay, to God be the glory, he let me write a song. And we are going to sing it for your hearing. This is about to become the Siloam anthem.
All right.
Okay? This is about to be the Siloam anthem. And we're going to invite God's presence to dwell here. Amen? So this is a fun beat. So we invite you to stand up and clap your hands and sway with us and have some fun worshiping God. Is that all right?
Yeah.
All right, let's get it.
Come, Lord Jesus, you can dwell here. Come, Lord Jesus, make your abode here. Come, Lord Jesus, this is your dwelling place. Come, Lord Jesus, we fall down on our face. Come, Lord Jesus, you can dwell here. Come, Lord Jesus, make your abode here. Come, Lord Jesus, this is your dwelling place. Jesus, you can dwell here. Come, Lord Jesus, make your abode here. Come, Lord Jesus, this is your dwelling place. Come, Lord Jesus, we fall down on our face. Come, Lord Jesus, you can dwell here. Come, Lord Jesus, make your abode here. Come, Lord Jesus, this is your dwelling place. Come,
worship him.
Oh, come dwell here. they fall down on our face. Come, Lord Jesus, you can dwell here. Come, Lord Jesus, make your abode here. Come, Lord Jesus.
Now I know y'all can do better than that. Come on, let's give a big hand clap of praise to God's women. Amen. Didn't they do a fabulous job? Oh, come on. Didn't they do a fabulous job? Come on, put your hands together. Tell God thank you.
Come, Lord Jesus. I like that. I'll have to steal that song. Yeah. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, he who is and is yet to come again. Amen. And I bring you greetings from my family from Dover, Delaware, Elder Ellis B. Loudon, Jamie, and Christian Lake, and my son, Oshan, and my grandson, Zia Lake. So they welcome, they say, hi, they're probably watching. Oh, now it's God's time. I am just so humbled. Just the Holy Spirit has just showered down on me. I tried to change this song several times, but God said no. He says to tell your story and then sing the song. My story is I suffered a bad depression in December and went into early part of this year. And I contemplated suicide. And so at work, one of our associate general secretaries said, if you're struggling, get some help. And I talked to then the general secretary and I said, I'm in trouble. I don't know what to do. And he said, Joyce, get some help. And I have a vocal coach. And we were doing, I said, I can't sing. I just can't. And the tears was flowing. Yeah. She said, no singing, we're going to talk. She got me through. But the most amazing thing happened when I said about the committing suicide, it's just God started dispatching angels. I was receiving phone calls, and people was lifting me up, and they were texting me, and said, and one good friend, she said, no, we're not going to lose you. We need you. And in my head, I'm like, what you need me for? But it was just so much stuff that went on, and I didn't know how to clean out my closet. So that's where I was. So somebody else is struggling, but all along, God was pulling me back. He was pulling me back. And through my tears, I could see him pulling me back. And I talked to my children. I said, I can't do this no more. And they said, oh, Mom, we can't lose you. So Dad had to step up. You understand? Sometimes our plate gets so full, we try to balance everything and do everything. I can't do that anymore. It's got to be about self-care and me. And so I had my reprimanding, and I got my other one this morning from Sister Massey, because I said I wasn't singing anymore. And I have been put in my place. So I hear you. and God has dealt with me. So what he laid on my heart is this song. He's been faithful. He's been faithful.
Whoever.
delivered anybody else in the house. If God has been faithful to you, clap your hands and give him some glory. If God has been good to you, clap your hands and give him glory. I don't know about you, but he's been faithful to me. He's been kind to me. He's been loving to me. He kept my mind. Come on, has God kept anybody? Listen, when you can't keep yourself, God will keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on him. Come on, somebody, clap your hands. I need some worshipers in the house. Where are the worshipers? Now I need some praises in the house. Don't play with it. I need some real praises. I need some real worshipers. I need somebody that will raise their hand and tell God, thank you. Listen, I just want to serve notice on somebody. They said, God is reigning. I need you to know he's reigning right now in the house. And I need you to know that he's already here. So whatever you need, it's in the house. Whatever you want, it's in the house. God has made provisions for this house to be blessed. I don't know about you, but I'm expecting my miracle. I don't know about you, but I'm expecting my deliverance. I don't know about you, but I'm expecting my finances to be increased. I don't know about you, but God is getting ready to do something in this house. My left foot wants to testify, but I'm trying to keep it still. Then my right foot said, I'll join my left foot. I'm getting ready for my miracle. I'm getting ready for my blessing. I'm getting ready for God to do what he said he would do. Clap your hands and give him glory. Claim it in the name of Jesus. Claim it in the name of Jesus. It's already done. Woo! Hallelujah. He's been so faithful. He's just like that. He's a good God. Woo! Hallelujah. Is there a hallelujah in this house? Yay, God. Yay, God. I thank you. Hey! Hallelujah. He's working it out right now. I hear the Holy Ghost telling me to tell y'all, whatever you left at home, God is at your house fixing what needs to be fixed. He needed you to leave so that he could have his way in your house when you get home. When you get home, it's going to be a different story in your house. Now, if you believe it, give God some praise. It's already done. Already done. Already done. Already done. Thank you. It's a done deal. It's a done deal. Woo! If you really believe it's already done, clap your hands and give God glory all over the house. Our God and our Father, we say thank you for this moment in time. We thank you, God, for your presence and your train that has already filled the temple. So God, right now, we're going to give you glory. We're going to give you praise. We're going to lift your high and holy name. So God, we thank you right now for those who have come into this house to receive a word from you, God. We thank you right now for how you kept us. We thank you right now, God, for your word that you have sent. So God, right now, in the name of Jesus, I decrease. I hide behind that old rugged cross. And God, right now, word these lips of clay. God, in the name of Jesus, articulation of speech and clarity of thought is what is desired right now. So God, we thank you in advance. Hallelujah. We receive it, God, in advance. Oh God, I thank you right now. Continue to bless these, your precious people. Keep us, God, in the name of Jesus. We're going to give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. It belongs to you. Clap your hands, people of God, as you praise your way down. Hallelujah. I just have a quick question. I know some of us are going through some things, and I want to thank this dear sister for your transparency on today. You don't know, but you helped somebody. You helped somebody in this house. You helped somebody out there. And for all of us that are going through something, I just want to ask a quick question. Do you still have a hallelujah way deep down in your belly? Anybody got a hallelujah anyhow? I just want to know if anybody's got a hallelujah anyhow praise. Things aren't going the way I want them to go, but hallelujah anyhow. I don't feel like I really want to feel, but hallelujah anyhow. I don't have everything that I want to have right now, but hallelujah. Anyhow, thank God for Jesus. We certainly honor the Lord on today. I just thank God for being God. Hallelujah. We certainly want to honor the angel of this house. Come on and help me celebrate the Reverend Dr. Randall M. Harris. Come on, let's celebrate this precious gift to this house. God bless you, sir. Appreciate you. Appreciate the friendship. Amen. Over the years, we just thank the Lord. I thank God for Sister Tammy Thompson and Sister Evans and Sister Yvonne Massey. Amen. They're friends of mine. Thank God. Thank God for all of the officers and members that make up this great body. Amen. I thank God for you, you and you. Thank God for my dear sister and my friend. Pastor Baxter is in the house, y'all. Oh, my God. This is an awesome one. You already know that. You already know that. And I just thank God for you, my sister and my friend. Thank God for all of you people of God. Thank God for the women of Siloam. Amen. Amen. You all know you have a special place in my heart. And thank God for the men as well. We need each other. Amen. To make this work. Amen. I thank God I've got family with me on today. I thank God I've got my grandbabies here, y'all. I just tell you, I thank God for my grandbaby. I tell people everywhere, it's Jesus, Jace, and Jan in that order. Okay, y'all know I'm Jan and he's Jace, and we know Jesus. Amen, amen. Thank God for I've got a spiritual son in the house. Amen. Thank God for my son, Marshall Baker. He's here. He promised me he'd be here. He's here. My sister's here. My daughter, my son. I'm just so, listen. How many of you know there's nothing like family? Amen, amen. And we're just so very grateful. I thank God for everybody, everything that's going through the house. Thank you, woman of God. Thank you for your gift and using your gift and how God is making room
for you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank God. Thank God for your theme on today, women walking in the word. Three words that I would like to leave from you that I gathered from your thought, and that is this: watch your step. Watch your step. To walk in God's word is to walk in God's ways. To walk in the word is to also walk in the spirit. God, the Holy Spirit, he breathed out the very word of God. And in the original Hebrew, the word translated as walk means to live, now watch this, or behave in a specific manner. In the Hebrew, again, it's translated to live or behave in a specific manner. When we walk in the word, people of God, the word becomes our focus. When we walk with God, God becomes our focus. And if we would all be transparent, like our sister here on today, and be honest, we would admit that we didn't always walk in the word. We didn't always have a relationship that we have with God that we have now. But thanks be to God for his grace and his mercy. I don't know about you today, but I'm so glad that mercy rewrote my life. Mercy rewrote my life. Watch this. Compassion rewrote my life. Forgiveness rewrote my life so that I could walk in the word. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that God let me off the hook. He let us off the hook, and he didn't give us what we really deserved. Come on, somebody. Anybody glad for mercy in the house? And I'm so glad for mercy's cousin, goodness. Because, see, the Bible said that goodness and mercy shall follow them all the days. Listen, people of God, if we're walking in the word, you've got grace and you've got mercy following you. So why don't you just very quickly turn with me to the book of John. The book of John, I'll be in the fourth chapter, if you will. We're going to jump around in this particular chapter, if that's all right with you on today. Amen, amen. I'm just so excited to be here on today. Thank you for the invitation that comes over and over again. I do not take it lightly when I stand in this sacred place before God and his people. I was just giving you an opportunity to find John 4. Amen. And if you have it, say amen, amen, amen. And the word of God says, I'm going to read first from 4 through 19. Now he had to go through, somebody say through, Samaria. So he came to a town in Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of ground Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, he had to walk to where he was going. There was no Uber, there was no Lyft, there was no public transportation. He was tired from his journey, so he sat down by the well. It was about noon. When a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" You see, his disciples had gone into the town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "You are a Jew. I am a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink? For Jews do not associate with Samaritans." Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water." "Sir," the woman said, "you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as did also his sons and livestock? Jesus answered, everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But, somebody say but, whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water welling up to eternal life. The woman said to him, sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and to have keep coming back here to draw water. He told her, go call your husband and come back. I have no husband, she replied. You see, it's good to be honest with God. Jesus said to her, you're right. When you say you have no husband, the fact is you have had five husbands, and the man you know now is not your man. What you have just said is quite true. Sir, the woman said, I can see that you are a prophet. We're going to skip down a couple verses, but first, before we do that, I have 4 points of interest, along with a few highlights, if I may. Number one, the main characters, Jesus, who was a Jew, and the woman, who was a Samaritan, who represents a mixed race of people. These two coming from different cultures that did not get along. Point number two, most Jews would not have traveled through Samaria. They would have gone around Samaria because of their differences. Point number three, the woman was alone and Jesus was alone for different reasons, but their being alone actually brought them together. Little did she know, this is point number four, it was going to become a spiritual moment when she thought it would be a natural moment. Look at this. Look at what happened on this particular day. The text lets us know that Jesus was traveling from Jerusalem to Galilee with his disciples, taking the most direct and quickest route through, hold on to the word through again, Samaria. Jesus was tired and he was thirsty. So he decides to sit by Jacob's well while his disciples went to get him something to eat. Well, again, it's about noontime. It's the hottest time of the day. And the Samaritan woman came to the well. Watch this. She walked to the well at this inconvenient time to draw her water. Why is she walking at this inconvenient time, the hottest day, time of the day, to get water? I'm so glad you asked. The reason why she went to the well to draw water at the hottest time of day, instead of in the morning or in the evening hours, which were the cooler times of the day, was because her sisters, her girls, and the people in her community knew what kind of life she was living. Wow. At one point, she was probably a part of the gossip. But if you know, sometimes when things happen in our lives, we become the gossip. So girlfriend said, listen, I know I probably gossiped about some other folk, but now I'm not in the club. I'm not in the sister circle anymore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go where nobody else is going. I'm going to the well where nobody else is going to the well, so I don't have to hear them talking about me. I don't have to see what they're saying and what they're doing. Can I help somebody in here today and let you know sometimes it's better to be by yourself? Some things can happen when you're by yourself that may not happen when you're with a whole lot of people, because, see, sometimes they can hinder your blessing. Sometimes they can hinder your walk. Sometimes they can put doubt in your mind. So it's better sometimes to be by yourself. I don't mind being by myself sometimes, because when I'm by myself, I can hear clearly now. I'm by myself, I don't have to hear all the noise that somebody's going to try to put in my ear. When I'm by myself, he walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me that I am his own. I'm just saying. You see, she had a lot going on in her life. Don't we all? And maybe, I don't know, but maybe some of the things going on in her life also went on in the lives of some of her sisters. But guess what? Their card may not have been peeped yet. Some of us, we come into church, come Sunday after Sunday, whole lot going on. But are we really walking in the word? So I just came to tell you today, real quick, watch your step, watch your step. Look at somebody and say, watch your step. So we know that she's going to the well by herself. And if you're going to get some water, you got to have something to put the water in. So she goes prepared and she's got her bucket. And she shows up. She shows up after walking to the well. And she shows up and she meets Jesus. You see, there's going to be some circumstances in our lives that will sometimes allow us to have a time when we're seeking one thing, but Jesus has something else in mind. So I just want to say, being alone and by herself worked in her favor. This is what I like about Jesus. Not only did he know her history, but he still accepted her and ministered to her because he knew her future. There are going to be some folk that they know about you back then. They think they know about you right now. And they have planned a future for you. But I'm here to tell somebody what Jeremiah 29 and 11 said. He said, for I know the plans I have for you. I don't care what they say. I don't care what they do. But I know the plans I have for you. And I'm so glad that the Lord said plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Look at somebody and say, I've got a great future because God said so. Now clap your hands and give him some glory for your future. You're walking into your future. You're going somewhere because God said go. Women of God, men of God, we gotta walk like we're going somewhere. We gotta look like we're going somewhere. We gotta pray like we're going somewhere. Clap your hands and give God. Remember. I told you to hold on to the word through. He didn't go around girlfriend situation, but he went through it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad he didn't go around my situation. But I'm glad that he went through my situation. He went through my circumstance. He went through your sickness. He went through everything that life brings to us. But instead, I'm so glad that when he went through, not that he had to be reminded, but he goes through so he can fix what needs to be fixed. He went through so he could actually finish what he started. There is a deep, heavy conversation between Jesus and this woman about water. I could tell you some things about water right now, but right now I'm really interested in the walk. Okay. Remember, she walked there, prepared to draw water from the well. I mentioned that she had her bucket. But when she got there, she sees Jesus who basically is telling her, you really don't need this bucket if you listen to what I have to say. And can I help somebody today and let you know that you don't need a whole lot of stuff in your life if you would just listen to what Jesus has to say. Sometimes we're carrying a whole lot of stuff, people of God, that we don't need to carry. Just listen to what Jesus has to say. And Jesus said to her, he said, I've got something better than what's in this well. He said, I've got something that you will never thirst again. I've got some living water that refers to eternal life, that water that would satisfy her soul's desire that only he could provide. Remember now, this woman had never met Jesus before. And he's offering to give her something that would change her life. And not only that, he knew her business. Can I help? Listen, y'all, he knows your business. You can hide it from the pastor. You can hide it from people that you're in relationship from. You can hide it from your boss. But I came to tell somebody, Jesus already knows your business. He knew that girlfriend had five husbands and was now living with a man who was not her man. How about that? And see, John 8:12 says Jesus was letting her know. He said, but I am the light of the world. What he was trying to say to her was, girlfriend, if you follow me, you won't have to watch this walk in darkness. Real quick, watch this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. It was 12 noon, so it was light outside, right? But guess what? She walked to the well in darkness. Some of us, even though it's daylight, we're walking in darkness. But thank God for Jesus, because we don't have to walk in darkness. Remember, she walked to the well to fill that natural bucket, and her natural need was the water from Jacob's well for her household. But after walking, watch this, into the word. Y'all didn't catch it. I'm gonna be at the restaurant eating my dinner, and somebody gonna say, oh, I got it. Listen. Girlfriend walked into the word. And people of God, when you walk into the word, your life changes. When you walk into the word, your situation changes. When you walk into the word, things happen in your life. Clap your hands, and I dare you to take a step and walk into the word. So girlfriend walked into the word. And guess what? when she walked into the word, she left going in the right direction. When you walk into the word and you abide in the word and the word abides in you, your direction will change. She was excited to get back into town to tell the people what happened. But you know what? People being people, watch this, us being us, in the communities that we live in, girlfriend was excited about going back into town because she had accepted God's invitation through his son, Jesus Christ, to get her some water that she would not have to worry about being thirsty again. And so let me just tell you what happened. In verse 25, the woman said, I know that Messiah is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us. Then Jesus said, I, the one speaking to you, I am he. am he. I am the one that can change your life. Just then his disciples, they came back and they were surprised to find him talking with a woman, but no one answered, what do you want or why are you talking to her? Then leaving her bucket, her water jar, the woman went back to town. This is the point I'm trying to make. She went back to town and said to the people, she said, come here. Listen, you know how sometimes when our children act up, I had my grandbaby over and I kept calling him. And he knows his name, you know, and I kept saying, Jace, come here. Gigi wants you, come here. He would look at me and then he would just turn around and do something else. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Jace, I'm talking about you right now. Listen, so I would say, come here. See, sometimes you got to get up close and personal. And you come on with me. And you guys say, come here. I need you to come see a man. And see, guess what? Not only did she say, come see a man, she told them where they could find the man. See, it's not just enough to tell somebody about Jesus. That's part of what you're supposed to do. But then you're supposed to lead them to Jesus. I'm so glad that somebody, not only did they tell me about Jesus, but then they led me to Jesus. They took me to where he was. And they told me, come see a man. Come on, somebody. I need somebody in the house to go and see a man. If you don't know the man, I can introduce you to the man. I can introduce you to the one and only superstar. The one that can do anything but fail. We find girlfriend now is running back into town. Watch this. She walked out, but she ran back. So I can only imagine, like I said, us. Can you imagine some of them women in town say, oh, here she go again. Who's she after now? My man is in the house. She can't have him. Looking through the blinds, saying, calling this one, calling that one, texting this one, texting that one. Y'all be careful who you call, be careful who you text. Because you don't know what God can do for somebody between then and now. So she goes back into town. She's excited as she should be. She gets back into town and she tells the people, come on. Y'all got to come and see this man. Because guess what? I found out when she left, she just started running. See, when you get excited about something, especially Jesus, Pastor Baxter, you start running with a quickness. And guess what? She forgot her bucket. But did she really need the bucket? Because let me tell you what the bucket represented. The bucket represented the old. The bucket represented what she left behind. The bucket represented her past. She didn't need anything but her mouthpiece to go back into town to tell the people about the man that she met. And understand this, women and men of God. There is nothing going on in your life today that catches God by surprise. When a situation, watch this, causes you to be exposed, start walking in the right direction. Imagine her just getting into town. Because guess what? Instead of somebody saying something sideways out of their mouth, what they should have said was, here comes the evangelist. What they should have said was, here comes the proclaimer. What they should have said was, here comes the preacher. What they should have said was, here comes the encourager. Because guess what? After you have had an encounter with Jesus, I don't know about you, but I looked at my hands and my hands looked new. I looked down at my feet and they did too. When you have an encounter with Jesus, your whole person will change. You won't look the same way you look when you before you met him, but Jesus will make a difference in your life. Clap your hands and give God glory. Colossians 1:10, and I'm almost through. So, thank you so much. So, as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord. Watch this. Fully pleasing to him. Bearing fruit in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. In our walk with God, our desire should be to please him. Sidebar. I love everybody. God knows I do. I appreciate everybody. You have a special place in my heart. But I am living to please an audience of one. Because I know that there's going to be some things that I might do that may not please you. Forgive me. But I'm living to please an audience of one. And that is the Lord God Almighty. God showed just how inclusive, how all-encompassing he is by imparting into this woman of a different culture. Listen, can't we all just get along? This is not about your zip code. This is not about your status. This is not about your title. This is not about your position. But this is about your walk with the Lord in the Word of God. Jesus just might have to use our stuff, our story. And this was all before I heard what you had to say. Confirmation. God will have to use some of our stuff, our story, our testimony, our history, to bring another sister to the well. Whatever it takes, use my story. Whatever it takes, use my stuff. Because this is about building the kingdom of God. Because of life situations, unknowingly, this woman walked her way into the Word and ultimately found herself walking with something from the Word. Your guided scripture for this occasion, Psalm 119, 105, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. God's word became a lamp for her feet and a light on her path. Charles Price Jones put his pen to paper and wrote this hymn. I will make the darkness light before thee. What is wrong, I'll make it right before thee. All thy battles I will fight before thee. And the high place, hey, I'll bring down. When thou walkest by the way, I'll lead thee. On the fatness of the land, I'll feed thee. And a mansion in the sky, I'll deed thee. And the high place, hey, the high place, somebody say the high place, I'll bring down. It should be every woman's desire and every man's desire to walk with God and to please him. In the book of Amos, the 3rd chapter, the 3rd verse, it says to walk with God means you agree with him and his ways. Anybody here today agree with God? When we agree with God, we agree with his ways. When we agree with God, we agree with his words. And even when we don't understand, we agree because he knows what's best. People of God, know that God has gone before you and prepared the way. Just keep walking. He's prepared the way for you to walk in his joy. So just keep walking. He prepared a way for you to walk in his love. So just keep walking. He prepared the way for you to walk in his peace. So just keep walking. He prepared a way for you to walk in his hope. So just keep walking. He prepared the way for you to walk in his loving kindness. So just keep walking. He prepared the way for you to walk in his goodness. goodness and mercy. So just keep walking. I want to encourage somebody today to remind you the steps of a good man, the steps of a good woman are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in her way. He delighteth in his way. So just keep walking. So just keep doing. So just keep praising. So just keep living. God's got something in store for you. Just walk the walk and talk the talk. Just live the word. Just breathe the word. Just eat the word. Just meditate on the word both day and night. God got something good for you. His plans are for you to prosper in his way. Clap your hands and give him glory. Nobody can do for you what God can do for you. So women of God, men of God, watch your step. Watch where you're going. Holy Spirit just said to me, let the people know, when you are in a relationship with God, you can't walk with everybody. You can't let everybody walk with you. I have a lot of acquaintances, but very few friends. On purpose. Because not everybody wants to go where you're going. Not everybody is going in the right direction. I will pick you up in my car and take you, give you a ride, but the moment you start telling me where to go and how to get there, you better hope there's a stop sign or a traffic light. And the reason I say this, I've been living this life too long. Pastor, too long to let somebody steer me in the wrong direction. I'm getting too old now. Now, maybe 15, 20 years ago, you may have caught me, but you can't catch me now. Because I made up in my mind that I'm going to walk with Jesus. I don't know about you, but how many folk are determined to walk with Jesus? Come on, if you really want to walk with him, clap your hands and give him glory. If you really want him to walk with you, clap your hands and give him glory. How about this? I'll say, yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. Guess what? I fell in love with Jesus. And when I fell in love with Jesus, I made up my mind that I would walk with him. Can you just play a little bit of falling in love with Jesus? Y'all did that the last time I was here. And I just carried that thing with me. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing that I could ever done. Because when I fell in love with him, my walk changed. When I fell in love with him for real, my talk changed. When I fell in love with him for real, my direction changed. And I'm so grateful today. Watch this, that I'm still in love with Jesus. Oh, falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love. Come on, help me. With Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever done. One more time, falling in love. Falling in love with Jesus. You see this woman, she fell in love. falling in love with not just any man, but she fell in love with Jesus. Oh my, I'm so glad about it. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever, ever done. In his arms, didn't he do this for you? I'm so glad he did it. In his arms. I'm never disconnected. Oh, in his arms. There's no other place. There's no other place I'd rather be. Come on, one more time. Falling in love, falling in love, falling in love. I'm so glad I did it. So glad I fell in love. Jesus, with Jesus, what's the best thing I've ever done? Falling in love, I dare somebody to fall in love this afternoon. And all you have to do is say, Jesus, I love you with my whole heart. And if you haven't said it yet, Jesus, forgive me if I've done anything wrong that's not pleasing to you. All you have to do is just fall in love with him. It's the best thing I've ever, ever done. In his arms, one more time, one more time. Somebody needs Jehovah Jireh right now. Somebody needs the provider right now. I don't know about you, but when I'm in his arms, when I'm with him, I feel so protected. And what I like about him, he'll never disconnect us. In his arms, I feel protected. Best place I'd ever, ever done. It was the best thing I did. Over 50 years ago, I fell in love with him. Things happen in life, but I'm so glad that, Pastor Baxter, I never fell out of love with him. And because of the relationship I had with him, I knew who I could go to when I needed help. I knew who I could go to when I needed real help. Come on. I just want to help somebody here. Y'all stop telling your business to everybody. Because not everybody wants to see you blessed. Not everybody wants to see you happy. That's why I did this. Falling in love with Jesus. Because I know he wants what's best for me. Falling in love. He wants me to have. He wants me to prosper. Because of the future he has for me. Falling in love with Jesus, with Jesus, with Jesus, with Jesus, with Jesus, with Jesus. It was the best thing that I've ever done. Just hum it. Was the best thing I've ever, ever done. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord all over the house. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord all over the house. Hallelujah. Come on, celebrate God for your relationship with Him. Celebrate Him because He's the best thing that ever happened to you. Pastor, if this is all right, I never want to take for granted that everybody that has come into the house has this relationship with God. Don't ever want to take for granted, Pastor Baxter, that everybody is walking in the right direction. And this is not to put you out on blast. This is not about to call you out. But it's a part of my assignment to make sure that if you want this relationship, you can have it right now. This afternoon is not promised, let alone tomorrow. When you turn on the news these days, our children not even safe going to school. It's praying time, and it's time for us to get our house in order. So if there's somebody that does not know Him, you don't even have to walk. Just wave your, put your hand up, put your right hand up. Just simply say, I need Jesus, and I need Him now. And all you have to do is say, Lord, I'm a sinner that needs to be saved by grace. And don't you know that He will hear you? Remember now, you don't have to tell Him everything because He already knows your business. But all you have to do is say, God, here I am. Here I am. I need You. I want to fall in love with this man. So right now, Father God, that's the first call. If you don't know Him and you want to be saved, I want you to just say, I'm a sinner. I need to be saved by grace. Save me, Lord. And forgive me, Lord. And try me one more time. The second call is this. If there's sickness in your body, just lift your hand right now. If there's sickness in your body, lift your hand right now. I came in here this morning with a terrible pain going down my whole left side. But can I tell you it's gone now? It's because I'm walking in the Word. It's because I fell in love with Jesus. That's the second call. If there's somebody that's sick today, or if you know somebody that's sick today, just stand in proxy for them. Because God is yet a healer. He's yet a way maker. The third call is this. If you want to stand in proxy for somebody that you know is not saved and you're asking God to save them, you want God to touch them, touch their mind, touch their body, touch their soul. You stand up for them. I tell you, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think. Salvation is a light thing to God. Healing is a light thing to God. Deliverance is a light thing to God. He can do it. He can do it. He can do it. And all we have to do is believe. So if you are in any one of these categories, let us bow our head and look to the Lord, our God and our Father. We say thank You for salvation that is in this house right now. God, we thank You for how You've touched minds, bodies, and souls on today. So God, in the name of Jesus, keep them, God, covered with Your blood. In the name of Jesus, if they don't have a church home, God, here's a house, here's a house, here's a house. So God, in the name of Jesus, lead them and guide them and direct them into all truth. And then God, in the name of Jesus, for those who may be sick in their bodies, we know that You are yet a healer. We know, God, that You can take care and fix anything, God. God, we know that You can mend anything. We know, God, that You could heal anything, all sickness and all manner of disease. God, we thank You for Your healing power. There's nothing You made that You can't mend. So, God, whatever that pain is, God, whatever the doctor said, God, in the name of Jesus, whose report will You believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. Heal it, God, in the name of Jesus. Fix it, God, in the name of Jesus. Blessed God, in the name of Jesus. We stand in proxy for our loved ones right now in the name of Jesus. God, those in our families that may not be saved, God, save them, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we stand, God, on behalf of them right now, knowing that you can do it, God. There's nothing too hard for you, God. So, God, do what you've done in times past. Show up. Show up in the lives of your people. Show up and show yourself mighty. Show yourself strong in the name of Jesus and have your way. We thank you for this. We praise you for this. We count it as already done in the heavens. And God, just release it in the natural. And God, we're going to clap our hands right now and tell you thank you for it. We're going to clap our hands right now and give you glory for it. We're going to clap our hands right now and give you praise for it. We're going to clap our hands right now and give you honor for it. Come on, people of God, clap your hands all over the house and tell God, thank you for this. Thank you for this. Come on, somebody shout, thank you for this. Thank you for this. Thank you for this. Thank you for this. Hallelujah. People of God, watch your step. God bless you.
Oh, come on, God, and give God some glory. Have you been blessed by the word? Can we just stretch our hands towards Evangelist Ruise? Father, in the name of Jesus, even right now, we ask that you would refill this woman of God for everything that she has poured out. We thank you, Lord God, for the word of God that you have allowed to flow through her, Lord God. We thank you for the warning to watch our step, Lord God, and to be careful to walk in the word, God. We thank you for the reminder to fall in love and stay in love with Jesus. God, replenish her, refill her, Lord God, and cover her under your blood. In your son Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Evangelist Ruise, we don't have enough money in the world to give you. But we got a little something for you. It has been a marvelous weekend, hasn't it? Come on, ladies. It has been a marvelous, marvelous weekend. We have been filled. We have been equipped. We have been challenged to go forward, to walk in the word, to know who we are, to be in position, with posture, in poise, to walk and fulfill our purpose. Can the redeemed of the Lord say, so? So when you leave from this place, remember to watch your step. And to let your steps be ordered by the Lord. I'm going to turn it over to Pastor Randy for his closing remarks and the benediction, but we bless the Lord in Jesus' name.
Come on, everybody, say thank God. Come on, say thank God one more time. I just need to ask you one question. Isn't God good? Anybody on this side know that God's good? Anybody on this side know that God is good? Hallelujah, the Lord is good. I snuck in to a couple of the sessions on yesterday. It got so good I didn't want to leave. But I'm telling you, it is marvelous to be able to be in the presence of God. And I know some of us are prejudiced when it comes to watching the women flow, because some of us don't like it and some of us do. But I'm one of the ones that love it. And Dr. Ruise, I'm watching my step. I'm so glad. Joyce, you know I love you, girl. I love you. I love you like peanut butter and jelly. Amen. I'm just grateful to the Lord for what God has done. And I'm truly grateful for what the Lord is continuing to do here in Siloam. I got one last question. Any blessed people in Siloam? All the blessed people, stand on your feet. Let's get ready to go home. Amen. Father God, we just thank you for what you have poured out to us on this week. Other than lifting our voice and saying those two words, God, we don't know how else to express ourselves. But Lord, collectively, we just say thank you. Thank you for what our ears heard, what our eyes have seen, what our hearts have felt, God. I don't know what you're going to do with the women from now on. But God, we're going to try to catch up, us men. We're going to get started. And Father God, we just love you for loving upon us. Thank you, God, for being the justifier in our lives. And God, you could have gotten rid of us a long time ago. But thank you for mercy and cousin grace. Bless us, God, as we get ready to leave from this place, but never from your glorious presence. And Father God, we just love upon you because you loved us even when we didn't love ourselves. Father God, bless our preacher. Continue to keep her. Continue to use her. God, continue to shine upon her. For Lord, we love you and we thank you. We thank you and we love you. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior, who is Jesus the Christ, the love of God, and the sweet communion of Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forever. Let all God's children say amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Pastor Frieda.